Hi everybody, this is Dr. Taqavi, instructor for the course of conflict resolution and negotiation process. The code of the course is L86851. Welcome to the course. Your course takes is Interpersonal Conflict, Parker and Wilmot, 10th edition, 2017. And the conflict resolution and negotiation process has two major parts. The first part, conflict components, and the second part, special applications for the conflict resolution and negotiation process. In the components, we discuss about the nature of conflict, perspective of conflict, interests and goals, and the role of them in conflict. Power, the structure of conflict is based upon the power and conflict styles. And one of the most interesting topics in new trends in psychology, to emotions and affective science, emotions and conflicts. And at the part of application, we talk about how to analyzing conflicts, interpersonal negotiations, and sometimes intrapersonal negotiations, third party interventions, your mom, your colleague, your father, your friend, your wife, your husband, your children, maybe. They are the third part intervention, and the practice of forgiveness and the role of memory in forgiveness. As you say, forgive and forget. Forgetfulness is the part of the memory issues in forgiveness. So by detail, I want to know about the details of these topics. At the nature of conflict, we at first should have and should pay attention to interpersonal conflict. Depends on interpersonal communication, the role of communication, the role of dialogue in shaping any type of conflict. And the definition of conflict, why study conflict? Why? Because the conflict is the basic human part of any type of any kind of human relationships. And preventing disruptive conflict and explaining what is constructive conflict, what is destructive conflict, and understanding destructive conflict. Perspective on conflict, your personal history or family history, more reflections on your specific history, some parts of the history, your history, past life history, that is very significant, very meaningful, very specific for you. And your worldwide effects, how you think and feel about conflict. Perception is everything in conflict management. Negative views of conflict, negative perception on positive views, and insights from metaphors, from the symbolic word, and narrative frame conflict. Conflict, as I will say, your conflict is a part of self-narration, self-suggestion, self-talking that shapes your the meaning of the events, the meaning of the your life, and how do you perceive a specific conflict perception. And cultural perspective, it is based upon not cross-cultural for everybody in every culture and every nation. It is maybe culture-based. Interests and goals, types of goals, TRIP, T-R-I-P. The overlapping nature of TRIP goals. Goals change in interaction. One part in conflict is shared goals. When you don't have shared goals, it's a high range of possibility for occurring conflict, interpersonal or social. And goal clarity, clarification of goals and collaborative goals. And after that, the power, the structure of conflict is power, power, definition of power, a relational theory of power, interpersonal power and basis of power, assessing your power, how you can gather information about your power and balancing power constructively, not just destructively. And conflict styles for everything in psychology and management is a lot of styles, love styles and interpersonal styles, communication styles, and here is conflict styles. The nature of styles, what is the main core of this styles, assessing your style, how you can check your, what is your conflict styles. Will you avoid or engage to styles, avoidance, dominating, compromise, and obliging, integrating, and other things, and behind the style violence, it is not conflict, the style violence is the actual expression of anger and interaction dynamics, and flexibility creates constructive conflict. It is very, very, very important. Flexibility creates constructive conflict. And emotions in conflict, I said to you that a major part of today's trends and today's approaches in psychology is the focal point is the affective science, emotions, the study of emotions. And the scientific studying, a scientific investigation of emotions. Before that, we felt that as psychologists and managers and other professional humanity, we felt that it is thinking, emotion or feelings, and behaviors, after that behaviors, and final it is results. So you change your thinking, you change your feeling, you change your behaviors, you change your results. And now we know that it is not linear connection. Every part of the connection changes, other part will change. For example, if you only work on your emotions, your thinking and your behavior, and other part, your life result and actual result will change. Introducing emotion, misconceptions of emotion in conflict, especially anger, shame, guilt, fear, stress, anxiety. How does emotion function in conflict? What is the function of emotions in conflict? A model of emotions, we will provide you a pattern, an interactive model of emotions, finding feelings. You should label, you should name your feelings. It's very good for you for conflict management. The mid-range zone of effectiveness, and then the personal responsibility for emotional transformation. Wow, such a huge word, not change, not modification, it is transformation, not information. Okay, analyzing conflict at the second part, applications, macro level analysis and micro level analysis, conflict systems, comprehensive guides, and the second one, interpersonal negotiation, not intrapersonal, talking to yourself. Negotiation in everyday life, in culture, constructive argumentation, approaches to negotiation and competitive negotiation, integrative negotiation, and elements of principled negotiation. The language of integration is very, very, very important. When you have conflict with someone else, you should have shared meaning. When you don't have any shared meaning, you will be in conflictual situation. Language of integration, or integrated language, when you have a shared perception of something, is very good procedure, a very good point for manage the conflict or maybe for conflict resolution. Competitive phases and integrative phases. And third party intervention. The need for a third party. Sometimes you don't have any wisdom or any knowledge or any skills to resolve the conflict. And you will very, very, very soon change and convert your discussions to argument, your disagreement to argument, and your argument to conflict. So the third person, as an observer, as a judge, as a helper, as a counselor, as a psychologist, as a manager, as everybody can help you in resolution of your conflict between your wife, your husband, your child, your colleague, your teacher, your classmate, your roommate, and everybody that have common or shared goals, that can have or maybe have the common goals, the common meaning, shared goals, shared meaning. Okay, the third party can have, can give you some helps. You know, I think a very important, and give you some intervention for observe yourself and observe your role of yourself in the conflict. Advantages of using skilled third party, not everybody skilled for counseling, psychologists and social people or social workers that can help you. It is a skill because they should know the process and the stages of conflict and how to have intervention, to do intervention in conflicts. And they should know about the personality, typology of personality, over the other styles of personality. Informal help, sometimes it is informal. And conditions for helping, and cautious about informal intervention, especially for your family members, especially for your friends. They will give you informal intervention. They cannot give you or earning money for their work as a helper because they are not professional helper. Informal intervention is very good and very professional and very effective. And the practice of forgiveness. Forgiveness and reconciliation in the context, some definitions, what to forgive, some misconceptions about forgiveness, misunderstand misconceptions. When there is an imbalance of power, the matter of memory, as I said you before, forgiveness is a matter of memory. I want to forgive, but I cannot forget. Forgetfulness, forgetting is a matter of memory. Decisional process, should I analyze this? Should I process the forgiveness or should I have it make a decision about it? How process may lead to decision, getting a stock, and the personal and interpersonal dimensions of forgiveness instead of personal. Very important and interpersonal between you and others. And gestures and maybe sometimes postures and also body language, communicating forgiveness directly. The value and limit of apology and switching the point of view, POV, from which point you are looking at the issue, at the problem that you should forgive about it. And reconciliation, a later stage in the journey. Thanks that you are here. I will visit you in the class for the next 8 weeks. And I want to try to each other to learn it practically and to learn it experientially. Conflict resolution, not only as a matter of study for the academy, for the university, and pass the exams. See you. Have a good time.